Hey everyone, I am Dr. Raimunde. I'm one of the pediatricians at PAK. I promise this will only take about 3 minutes. Just hear me out. I want to talk about the long wait times at our office, why our kids are getting sick so much and so often, when to worry about it. I'm also including 7 tips on triaging your child at home. And if you reach to the end of the video, I'll give you some bonus tips on how to best reach us and get an appointment.
PAK Pediatrics presents.
Now, my patients know I say things straight, no chaser, so here goes. As you all know, it's been a crazy couple of months. This year, we have been seeing more sick kids than ever. Just like practices all across the country, we at PAK have been inundated with concerned parents. ER visits are seeing 14-hour wait times. Urgent cares wait times are up to 8 hours at times as well. And it really makes sense, too. We've been seeing kids that have been getting sick every 2 to 3 weeks with virus of the week. And I'll go over why we believe this is the case in a little bit. There's some bad news I want to get through first, but there's good news, too, I promise. Before all of that, I do want to let you guys know what PAK is doing for you guys during these hard times. In order to try to get all of our calls, all of your calls, our triage team has been working overtime, extra hours every single night. Go team. We really appreciate them. And we have placed a service where we call you back when it's your turn so you don't have to be on your phone, you know, with your phone to your ear, and you can check, you can tend to your child or do your daily duties or whatever. We also hired and trained more professional staff to answer the phones as well, as having our providers help with calls between seeing patients. We've also been working overtime answering portal messages. Unfortunately, some days our call volumes exceed 400 to 500 calls that we simply can't get back to all of them. We really, really wish we could. This is something that's been never seen before. And like I mentioned earlier, it's something that practices nationwide in primary care are experiencing. Many people feel that this is because PAK has expanded and we have, you know, a couple of new offices. And that would be a valid point. However, when we do expand and open an office, we staff that office with their own triage nurses and providers in order to accommodate the patient volume. It really, truly just is a bad season for illness. Now, let's talk about why we think this is all happening. So most of the kids that have been getting sick are those younger than 5 or 6 years of age. We've been seeing kids with on and off cough and congestion, different types of conjunctivitis, upper respiratory infections, bronchiolitis, and even GI bugs. It's been bad. The typical trend is that they're sick for about 5 to 7, even 10 days, and then they have 1 or 2 days that were symptom free, and then they get sick. Why? Well, because for the past 2.5 years, we've been living in a relative bubble. There are certain viruses that we come in contact with and give us illnesses at certain ages, and then we get immune to them and we don't get as sick from them again when we come in contact with them. I call these kitty viruses. However, due to masking, social distancing, isolation, increased hygiene, our children have spent the past 2.5 years in a relatively sterile environment when compared to previous years. Last year, kids did go back to school, but many were still masking, and then there was still some protection. This year, we're back at school, completely unmasked, and people have been getting more comfortable with gathering, sports, etc. So now those viral infections that should have been causing illness over 3 to 5 years are hitting kids all at once. Their immune systems are not used to being sick. They don't have that built-up immunity from the previous generation. Compared to the previous generations, that they would get these illnesses every 1 to 2 times a month. Pre-COVID, fall and winter, the first fall and winter was by far the harshest. Then they would get some immunity. The next winter was a little bit better. And by the 3rd or 4th, they were like attendance winners. Now we're seeing kids and even kids through college, they're getting sick over and over again. So that's all the bad news. The good news is that most of these illnesses are the kitty viruses we see every year, or we used to see every year, just now that they're back to back and all at once. So we know that most of us will do well. Most of our kids will recover. We know this winter will be tough, but knowing that these are the usual viruses we see every year is helpful because we get through them. And once our immune systems are built up, we're going to have our attendance champions again. The big question is, how can we tell if this is a back-to-back illness or is it something more severe? Well, here's some medical triaging for your child 101. Number one, most simple infections won't give a fever for more than 2 or 3 days. So if your child has a temperature of 100.6 or higher for more than 3 days, it could mean that something else is going on. However, if your child is younger than 3 months, always give us a call if they have a fever. Number two, thick green nasal discharge does not mean your kid has a sinus infection, or that it's a severe illness. It's pretty common for many viruses to do this, and it should get better after about 3 to 5 days. Thick nasal discharge lasting more than 2 weeks, however, is more likely to be a sinus infection. Number three, the first 3 to 4 days of an illness are typically the worst, but then they start to improve. As long as they are improving, it is normal for kids to have symptoms for up to 14 days. That's 2 weeks. Younger kids can be sick a little bit longer because it takes a few more days for them to clear it since they don't do a great job at blowing their noses. Number four, we know it's likely to be a new virus if your child has even 1 or 2 days of no symptoms. If your child is sick for more than 2 weeks or is not improving or develops a new symptom without having a break, then there's likely something else going on and he or she should be evaluated. Number five, sometimes what starts as a simple illness can progress to an ear infection, pneumonia, or sinus infection. So if your child is getting new symptoms at the end of 7 to 10 days or is not improving, you should call us. Number six, you should also call us or call 911 anytime your child is struggling to breathe. You can tell this is going on when their noses are flaring, the space between their ribs are sinking, or they have rapid labored breathing. Lastly, number seven, another reason to call is if you think your child is dehydrated. Signs of this are dry mouth, no tears, or decreased diapers, or decreased dark yellow urine. All right, sorry, I'm trying to get this under 3 minutes. Finally, here are some tips on how to navigate our busy offices now that kids are sick all the time and it seems like it's hard to get an appointment. It's almost guaranteed that there will be longer than usual wait times, both on the phone and in the office. Please try to be patient. You can be sure that we are attending other patients with the same care and love you will receive and expect from us. First tip, since we are booking so quickly, it may be hard to get in for a same day appointment, especially if calling later in the day. Try calling in the morning if you feel like your child needs to be seen. Second, for questions that can wait 1 or 2 days for a response, remember you can always use the portal message to get in contact with us. Third, use the symptom checker and our medication dose finder on our website. Many of our calls are questions that can be found using these tools on our website. As always, thank you so much for your patience and understanding. We are working as hard as we can to get your calls and to see your children as efficiently, safely, and with as much care as you have come to expect from us. Thank you so much for listening to this. Stay healthy. I'll see you.